Hail's been a big problem down across the southern counties this evening, and now we're watching more storms from Corning through Creston to the east here through Osceola again, and those are going to be moving back through Sheraton. So we have three severe thunderstorm warnings in effect currently, and they're going to be expiring over the next half an hour to 45 minutes. The one near Creston expiring at 9:30, then we have one expiring at 10 near Van Wert, and then also 10 o'clock now, a little bit later time for you in Osceola and Sheraton. Hail, wind, the primary threats. We've had reports coming in of hail the size of eggs near Murray. So these storms quickly pulse up, get the big hail going, and then they begin to just drop down heavy rainfall. The earlier batch of rain we had is now across southeastern or west central parts of Illinois and northeastern Missouri there. Another complex of storms diving into Kansas, and more rain out across the panhandle of Nebraska. If that one holds together, it could arrive in western Iowa as we head towards sunrise tomorrow morning. But at this point, it is not looking likely at all. Numerous reports coming into the lab this evening of hail and even some wind damage out there to a few buildings, knocking down some power lines in a few locations. And once again, the largest hail reports we're getting in have been golf ball and egg sized hail, but for the majority they're about 1 to 2 inches in diameter, and 1 to 2 inches of rain falling too. And this area is going to get another round of 1 to 2 inches of rain coming in from these current storms. Large hail is still a primary concern out there. Flash flooding concerns because the ground is already saturated. Wind damage is still a possibility, although most of the winds will be lower than 50 miles per hour. And at this point, the threat for tornadic activity is pretty low. By 9 p.m., most of that rain will begin to push off to the southeast, although we'll still see a few more thundershowers possible near Ottumwa through 10-11 p.m., but the activity becomes much more spotty at best. Staying dry overnight, by sunrise tomorrow morning, here comes that complex of rain moving in from Nebraska if it does hold together, but it shouldn't stick around all day tomorrow. Rain tracker showing an additional half inch across much of southwest Iowa, even an inch or more if you get one of those heavier thundershowers. Right now in Des Moines, we can see the lightning here from downtown, but this is far off to the south of us, now down near the Osceola area. 73 degrees right now in Des Moines. It's been a beautiful evening here, dry. South wind is nearly calm, and we have a pretty high dew point, so it's a little muggy out there. Tomorrow, we can't rule out an early morning thundershower, but most of the day will just be hot and humid. Thursday, here comes another chance for rain. Then the heat really builds in big time for the weekend. Morning lows will be in the 70s, afternoon highs in the 90s with sunshine. And with all the humidity, the heat index will top 100.